Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Happy Wednesday. If you're new here, my name is Alicia Shannon and I'm so glad that you decided to join me on this video. If you like this kind of content, make sure to subscribe below and check out my channel for more. In today's video, I am finally diving back into makeup reviews, and I will be reviewing the Reese's X Hip Dot collab. They came out with two palettes and two lipsticks. I only got one palette, and I did get both lipsticks as they come in a set. I'm very excited to get back into doing makeup reviews. If you like these kinds of makeup reviews, definitely let me know in the comments down below. And I can also do videos on my thoughts on some of the new releases, like the SpongeBob collab with Wet n Wild, and maybe some things that you've seen on TikTok. As you guys know, I've reviewed quite a few TikTok items. Before we dive into this video, make sure you are subscribed, as 80% of my audience is not subscribed, and I would absolutely love if you joined my family here on YouTube. For those of you who are subscribed, thank you so much. I greatly appreciate it. Make sure your notifications are on and they are set to all, so you get a notification every single time I upload. I think it's time to get into the Reese's review and try on. Let's go. So as I mentioned, we have two palettes in this collab. I did only buy one of the palettes because I like the color story of this one over the other one. There's also a lipstick set. You get both colors in this one package right here. I picked these products up at Hershey's Chocolate World, and I am a Hershey Park pass holder, so I did get a discount on this makeup. The palette was $18.95 without this pass holder discount, and the lipsticks were $16.95 without the pass holder discount. First, I'm going to dive into the Reese's palette. I really like this packaging. It looks just like the Reese's packaging, just obviously bigger. Let's open it up. So here is the actual palette component. It is white, the other one is orange, and this is cruelty free and vegan. So here is the Reese's palette, and I did smell it because I heard a lot of rumors saying it smells like chocolate and peanut butter, and I don't quite have that smell in it yet. Maybe it's because it is a new palette, but I will definitely keep you updated on that. I really love the way this palette looks. This shimmer right here is absolutely calling my name. So to begin this review, I'm going to swatch a few shades. I would like to see how they perform with just the swatches first. So I'm definitely going into this shade right here, which is called Snack Time, and I'm really interested in this one, which is Confection. Here are the two swatches. This is Snack Time and this is Confection. Now the glitter swatched pretty nicely, and it was really, really easy to pick up out of the pan using my finger, and I also think this shade swatched pretty nicely. They do look pretty pigmented, and I'm excited to see how they look on the eyes. I've never tried any previous Hip Dot products, so I'm excited to see if this brand's formula is any good. So let's dive into the actual eye look. Since these colors are so unique, I'm not quite sure of the look that I'm going to go for. I probably will stay a little neutral just for that first look and add this little pop of shimmer right here. I don't always go for orange shadow, but I might find a way to incorporate it in this look. I will say that I'm currently trying out new base primers, but I am going to go in with my trusty Urban Decay Potion Primer. That way I can give these shadows a fair shot. So now that my primer is down, I'm going to go in with White Chocolate as my base, and I'm just going to outline where I want the look to sit. Next, with the blending brush, I'm going to take the shade Indulge and put it in my inner to my outer V area to create the shape I like my eyeshadow to be in. So far, I'm really liking the way that these shadows perform. I am noticing just a little bit of fallout, which is something that you can kind of expect with most shadows. They are sort of blended together to make a little bit of a muddy color, which I don't necessarily love, but they are blending nicely, so that definitely is a plus. I wanted to make this look more about the cut crease than the actual outer shadows because I really want to highlight Snack Time, so it's okay that they're sort of blending together just a little bit. With the limited colors that we have in this palette, it was probably going to happen. We don't have too many transition shades. I'm going to take my my Tarte Shape Tape and cut the crease, and then I'm going to apply the Snack Time glitter, and I'm very excited to see how that is going to look on the eyes. The concealer sat really nicely on top of the eyeshadows. Now I'm going to go into Snack Time and tap my brush and hopefully pick up some glitter to put on top of that concealer. So this glitter is actually not going to cover the concealer the way I would like, so I am going to go into the shade Creamy and cover the concealer first and then put down Snack Time. So Creamy is now on the lid, and I like the way that it looks with just Creamy on. However, I will say that it was a little bit hard to get the shadow to pick up on the brush and then put it on my lid. I'm going to go back in with the shade Indulge and just blend that shade into the concealer that I have on, so that way there's not a harsh line. And now I'm going to go back into Snack Time and pick up some of that glitter and put it on top of Creamy. Snack Time definitely overcame Creamy. You can really only see Snack Time now. I'm not complaining because it is really pretty. I'm going to go back in and buff that out so there is not a harsh line. I'm going to go into Confection and put that on my inner corner. I definitely needed to incorporate this nice orange. And there is the look so far. I'm going to do the same on the other eye and I will be right back. All right, and I am back, and surprise, I did a totally different look. So I did the exact same base as the other eye, and the only thing I did differently was I did not add Snack Time to the lid. I thought the glitter overtook the shade Creamy, and I really wanted to see how good the shade looked on its own. So instead I opted to just have Creamy on this eye, and I put Confection on my brow bone and my inner corner here. I like how neutral this eye look is. It's very, very pretty and something you can wear out. There is a little bit of pop of color, which of course you don't have to do. I just added it in because it is a Reese's palette, so orange makes sense. The more I look at this eye, the more I dislike it. I think that Snack Time definitely overtook the whole look, and the two matte shades blended together in a way that I did not like. I did add eyeliner to this look, so that may be the reason why I like this one a little bit more, but I also just like the neutral of this look. I think it is a very nice look for this palette. I also do want to point out how messy this glitter is. It is sitting on my skin and it won't come off. It just kind of gets moved around even with a clean wipe. After looking at the shadow a little bit longer, I definitely prefer this look, but I do like them both. If I were to do this look again, I would tone down the glitter just a little bit because, like I said, it did overtake the look, and I think that's why I like this one more. I would definitely get into more thoughts in just a little bit, but I did want to try on the lipsticks. There are two. Let's open it up and see the shades. Here are the two lipsticks. We have a Peanut Butter Lovers and a Chocolate Lovers. The tubes feel like paper. I don't know how I feel about that, but I am excited to see what the shades look like. This is the chocolate shade and this is the Peanut Butter Lovers. I am not smelling any sort of chocolate or peanut butter on these. First, I'm going to try on the Peanut Butter Lovers tinted lip balm. So with a tinted balm, I am not thinking that there's going to be a lot of pigment, but I would like to see a little bit of color. Let's try it on. The packaging just comes off like this and the product twists up. Thank you. So here's what the Peanut Butter Lovers Tinted Balm looks like. I do like the way it looks as a tinted balm, but they are really creamy and soft and they feel really nice on the lip. I like this color. It is a nice neutral color. I'm excited to see how deep the Chocolate Lovers Tinted Lip Balm is, if it even is deep at all. I'm very interested in that, so let's try that one on. So here's what the Chocolate Lovers Lip Balm looks like, and I definitely think I prefer the Reese's over this one. I think this one is just a little bit darker than I would usually go for, but this is really, really nice. However, these are definitely transferable, and they are almost too creamy to the point that they move around too much. If I closed my lips when I was applying this, it would move and go somewhere I didn't want, so I did have to clean it up. And like I said, they're definitely not kiss-proof. I also feel like I am losing the color the more I talk. I can see parts of just my normal lip color coming through, and that probably is just because these products are not that pigmented. So now I want to go over the products that I used in this video from the Reese's X Hip Dot collection, and I want to talk about them, give them a review and everything. So I am going to start with the palette. So like I've mentioned, there are two palettes to this collection, and I got the white one. So I'm only speaking for the white palette in the collection. I'm sure they have the same formulas, but you never know, they could be a little bit different. This is such a cute color story. I love these colors. However, I don't know that this is the best eyeshadow formula that I've ever used. I think there are better shadow formulas out on the market, but I also don't think that these were absolutely horrible. On this eye, I definitely noticed the shadows were blending together and Snack Time took over the whole look. The overall look of the shadow isn't bad. I just think it was a little bit too much for the way I like my shadow. This is definitely a palette that multiple different people can use no matter your skill level. However, I will say that I did have some problems with Creamy. When I went to apply it on this eye, I really had to dig into the pan, and I did have a little bit of the same with this, but my concealer was a little bit wetter, so I think that might have helped with the shadow sticking on. I really like this confection shade. I just don't really know how to work it in with this palette. I'm sure there's people out there who know how to work it in and have ideas in their head, but to me, when I do a look, I think of a color scheme, and usually if I'm doing a neutral, that orange is not in it. Plus, with this palette being so small, I don't really know what I would pair with that orange. I mean, obviously you can pair the neutrals, but I would probably go for a different palette to pair this orange with, like Orange Glad by ColourPop. I also want to mention that I don't smell peanut butter or chocolate still, and I'm not quite sure if they actually claim that it smelled like either of those two scents, but I see it all over online, so I just wanted to let you guys know about that. Overall, I think this is an okay palette. I think you could definitely get some use out of it, and it is cute. It was an interesting product to work with, and I think I will try it out with the new bases I am trying to see if that does anything, but I overall enjoy the looks that I came up with. I thought that these were pretty easy to blend. I didn't really have any issues minus that little fallout and then the glitter just going all over. But then again, it is glitter, and that is something you see most often when you use a glitter product. I think the concealer sat really well on top of the eyeshadow, and I also think my eyeliner sits really, really well on top of the eyeshadow. So as for the palette, I'm going to give it a 6 out of 10. I like the eyeshadows, like I've said, but I don't think that they were absolutely perfect, and I don't know that this is a palette that I will always pick up. All right, let's talk lips. So first, I want to talk about the Reese's Tinted Balm. This was the lighter color, and I did enjoy this, although like I did mention, these balms are very creamy and they got in spots that I did not want them to be, so I did have to clean them up just a little bit. And I like this, but I don't know if this will be the one that I go to every single day. As for this one, pretty much the same thing. They are very, very creamy, so they slid and got in places I didn't want them to. I do like the color of this, however I do see it fading just a little bit and seeing my natural lip color coming through. And as for the tinted lip balms, I think I'm going to give them a 7 out of 10. I do enjoy them and I like the way that they look. They're a nice light wash of color, but like I said, they are not kiss proof, which means they transfer and they slid a little bit, and I would just like a little bit more pigment even though that they are tinted balms. So I'm not going to say that this collab is my favorite collab ever. I think it's a pretty decent collab, but I definitely was expecting a little bit more, and this is my first Hip Dot product, so I don't have anything to compare it to from the other Hip Dot collabs, but it wasn't bad. I probably will pick this up again to use the glitter in in certain looks, or the orange shade, just different shades and different looks. I don't know if I will ever put a look together from just this one palette again. I think this is a great accessory palette to other palettes. So there you have it. That was the Hip.x Reese's collab review. What did you guys think of this look? What did you think of the products? Did you pick up any products for yourself? Are you going to pick up any products for yourself? I would love to know your thoughts and anything about this collab, something I may have missed, or if your palette was formulated better. I would definitely be interested in knowing all of that. I hope you enjoyed this video. I'm so glad to be doing makeup reviews again. Let me know in the comments down below if you want to see more makeup reviews, what you want to see. I can do TikTok products again and any collab coming up. But I really hope you enjoyed this video. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, turn on post notifications, all of that, and I will see you in my next video. Bye. Feel